Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. How are you students? As you know that we are on chapter number 5, Message in a Bottle. And we have completed its translation and its starting page of exercise. You know that we have completed the exercise comprehension. Its second part and third part on page number 46. And today we are going to solve page number 47. Now students, it's B part, working with words. And the first one statement of this question is, put inverted commas in the following. So students, I would like to tell you that where you have to put commas. When you are going to describe the actual statement of any person, that what that person is saying, we have to enclose that statement in inverted commas. So students, whatever anybody is saying, we will write down in that statement in inverted commas. So let's start now. Look here students, the A statement is, what does it say? Cried Afia excitedly. As you know that Afia is saying that what does it say, so we have to put commas before and after this statement which Afia is saying, and at the end there is a full stop. Statement B, you're not foolish at all, said old Babu. So this is the statement of old Babu, and old Babu said, you are not foolish at all. So we are describing his words as he has said. So we will put inverted commas before and after this statement. C part. I don't know, replied Hassan. What Hassan is replying? That I don't know. So we write down inverted commas before and after this statement and at the end there will be full stop. D part. Why are you looking so sad? Asked old Babu. So students, this is a statement of old Babu and we are quoting as he has said. So we will put inverted commas before and after this question, that which old Babu said, why are you looking so sad? Part E, here is the boy's address, he said. So this is the statement, here is the boy's address. So we will put inverted commas before and after that. Okay students, now look at the question number 2. Here is a statement. Now add inverted commas, full stops, question marks and commas. So first I will elaborate that where you have to write down inverted commas and all these punctuation marks. As you know that students, whenever you are going to write down the exact words of the speaker, you enclosed that words in inverted commas. And when a sentence ends, we have to put full stop at the end of the sentence. If anybody asks a question, so we put question mark at the end of the sentence. And commas are used to segregate, to divide the part of a sentence. So we will use these all punctuation marks. These all are called punctuation marks, and we will put these punctuation marks according to the sentence. So look here, A part, we cannot read or write, can we? Replied us, Afia, quietly. So we can easily identify that these are the words of Afia. We can't read or write. And it is just a division that we have a question tag here, can we? So we will put question mark here. And replied Afia quietly, we will put full stop at the end of the sentence. And we will enclosed this statement in inverted comma. B part. Look, Babu, cried the children excitedly. Look, Babu. We will enclose this in inverted commas. Here will be exclamation mark. Cried the children. We will write down comma here. And at the end of the sentence, we will put question mark. So, students, here is C part. There is no school here, said Hassan. How can we learn? So the statement is starting here. We will enclose this in inverted commas. There is no school here. And we will segregate this with comma. Said Hassan, how can we learn? So we will enclose this statement in inverted commas also. And because this is a question, so we will put question mark at the end. Okay, student, now we move towards the next one. Complete these sentences in your notebook. So you have to tell the meanings. As you have learned vocabulary before, this is also a part of vocabulary, because here are some words given and you have to elaborate the meanings of these ones. So, first one is foolish means. Foolish means not clever, not bright. B part, wondered. Wondered means thought about with curiosity and doubt. Scampered. Scampered means ran quickly and lightly. Address. Address means the details of the place where someone lives. E part, deep. Deep means far into or below the surface of something. F part, nearly. Nearly means almost or very close to. Now students, look at these sentences. All the following sentences have grammatical mistakes. Try to find out the mistake and rewrite the sentences correctly. Can you explain why the sentences are incorrect? So students, these sentences are given here. I will give you the solution of the right one sentences and will tell you the reason that why these sentences are wrong. So look at the first one. The children did not went to school. The right answer of this sentence is the children did not go to school. As you know that when we are going to use did not, we will write the first form of verb. But in statement here, went is given, which is the second form of go. So when we use did not, we will write down the first form. That is why this is the mistake that we have corrected here. Now look at the B part. Old Babu helped the children to read the letter. So students, the right one option for this one is old Babu helped the children to read the letter. Reading is is reading given in the sentence, which is not right, because when we use to, the first form will be used. We will not use the participle form. The third one sentence is C part, Hassan haven't seen the letter before. The right answer of this is Hassan hasn't seen the letter before, because when we use the subject as a singular, we use has as a helping verb. We cannot use have with singular noun. So here will come hasn't. D part, where you go, where you were, asked Afia. So this is the question and there is also a grammatical mistake. We will write, where were you, asked Afia. Because it is a question and we use helping verb before the subject. So the right statement will be, where were you, asked Afia. Now students, we move towards the next one, page number 48. An E part is given here. It was friendly, isn't it? Now look at the sentence that when we are going to make the question tags, we use the helping verb according to the sentence. Was is used here, but in the question tag there is used, is used here. So this is the actually mistake and the right one solution will be, it was friendly, wasn't it? So you have to change the question tag. New Zealand is beautiful? No. This is not the right one question tag. We have to write the correct question tag according to the statement. So the right solution will be, New Zealand is beautiful, isn't it? Now students, look at the last one line. G, he didn't found the letter in a bag. As I have told you earlier that when we use did or did not, we use the first form of verb, but here the second form of verb is used here, found. So the mistake is here, we have to solve that and we will write the sentence in this way. He didn't find the letter in a bag. So students, I have elaborated all the mistakes. Now we are going to move towards the composition. Now students, look here, it is E part on page number 48. Using the words and the phrases given below, write a short story of one or two paragraphs of your own. You may use them in any order. Example, once a foolish man discovered that he was not able to get a job very easily. He sat with his head in his hands and... This is an example of a starting line given here and you have to use these vocabulary words and phrases. The first one is discovered, foolish, learn, sat with, great difficulty, wondered, able to, without any worries. So students, you have to use these words and you have to write down your own story. It's really a very good and healthy activity. In this way, you can, if you solve this and you practice this, you will be capable enough to write your own stories and it will enhance your creative writing. So students, I have prepared a story for you. You just take it as an example and prepare your own stories. Now students, look here. Once a foolish man discovered that he was not able to get a job very easily. He sat with his head in his hands and started thinking. Suddenly, his friend came to visit him. He encouraged him to learn a skill to start his personal business. The foolish man wondered about the idea and with great difficulty, he learned how to make baskets with sticks. Those baskets became very famous in his village. Now, without any worries, he became able to earn money. Students, all the vocabulary words which were given over there in the question, I have highlighted that words so that you can understand well that how you can utilize or how can you can use these words to make a story. So students, this is all your work and we have completed exercise of chapter number 5, message in a bottle from the workbook, from textbook, sorry. And this lesson is completed now and you learn it very well. Okay, take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.